morning and welcome to this morning's worship service. This recording is taken all the way from Sudwana Bay. Just want to welcome you all to God's creation as we honor God and remember and celebrate Women's Month. May we continue to worship the God that creates women and men as equals. Shall we pray together? Well, God, we thank you for another glorious day. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are present within our lives, that you are ever present and that you are always guiding us. Lord, we acknowledge that there are times where we are doubtful of your presence within our lives. We are at times so afraid to call out because what if you don't answer? And what if you do answer and don't answer the way that we want? Lord God, as we worship you again, as a collective body, as the body of Christ, as Littleton Methodist Church, we thank you that we are able to worship together. Lord, we acknowledge our shortcomings. We acknowledge our failures. We acknowledge that we have sinned and sinned against you and sinned against others. And for that, Lord God, we are truly, truly sorry. Lord God, hear the petition of our heart as we ask for your forgiveness, as we confess those things to you and ask, Lord, that in your mercy you would redeem us, forgive us and cleanse us. Come, Holy Spirit, and touch our hearts and touch our lives, touch our minds. Draw us closer to you and make us ever present or ever aware of your presence within our lives. May we be open to your guidance. May we be open to your wisdom. Lord, we continue to pray for our government, for our president, and we pray for strength for him as he comes against onslaught and attack. And Lord, he can't change South Africa in a day or an hour, but in small strides, in small steps, he can. And so, Lord, we pray for your strength and we pray for your protection over him. We pray against the corruption and crime in our country and pray that more and more this will be rooted out. Lord, those that are fighting corruption, give them strength. Lord, we ask for your strength as we worship you. We ask for your strength as we seek your wisdom. We ask for your strength as you allow us to enjoy a time of worship together. And so, Lord God, bless us. May we know that we are redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ. And so we hear the words of the risen Lord Jesus Christ as he says to us, "You are forgiven. Go and sin no more." Our call to worship this morning comes from Psalm 104, reading from verse 1 to verse 13. Praise the Lord, O my soul. O Lord my God, you are very great. You are clothed in splendor and majesty. He wraps himself in light as with a garment. He stretches out the heavens like a tent and lays the beams of his upper chambers on their waters. He makes the clouds his chariot and rides on the wings of the wind. He makes the winds his messengers, flames of fire his servants. He set the earth on its foundations. It can never be moved. You covered it with the deep as with a garment. The waters stood above the mountains. But at your rebuke, the waters fled. At the sound of your thunder, they took flight. They flowed over the mountains. They went down into the valleys to the place you assigned for them. You set a boundary they cannot cross. Never again will they cover the earth. He makes springs pour water into the ravines. It flows between the mountains. They give water to all the beasts of the field. The wild donkeys quench their thirst. The birds of the air nest by the waters. They sing among the branches. He waters the mountains from his upper chambers. The earth is satisfied by the fruit of his work. Thanks be to God for his word. We are so blessed to be able to read scripture and just consider what's outside. The trees, the birds, the animals, fish. My family was blessed last week to be at the coast, and what a glorious time just to be on the beach and enjoy God's creation. God gave us creation so that we may look after it, may consider how blessed we are and how privileged we are. As we celebrate Women's Month, may we also just consider what God has given us. If anything, lockdown has taught me personally to value what I have, and not monetary value, emotional, significant value that cannot be measured or equated with anything, but with the heart. And so as we worship the Lord our God, as we sing praises to Him, we honor Him and we give Him thanks. Let us worship together.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy. Faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord. Sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Good morning. Our gospel reading for today comes from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 16, verse 1 to 8. Mark chapter 16, verse 1 to 8. And it reads as follows. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed," he said. "You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples, and tell Peter. He is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you. Trembling and bewildered, the woman went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. Thanks be to God for his word.
Ever wonder why the woman came alone? Ever wonder why the men, particularly Peter and John, did not come early in the morning? The women in the Gospels do not take a prominent place. However, they have a constant place near Jesus. Jesus' ministry would not have been successful were it not for the woman who continued to minister to him and the other disciples. It reminds me that as the body of Christ, the church, we all have a role to play, some more prominent and others less prominent. Each have a role to play. The same as a puzzle. We love building puzzles, and before lockdown, Louise bought a 2,000-piece puzzle. We spend mornings, evenings, we would walk past and see a piece and quickly put it in and then get stuck there. And as we were nearing the end, our greatest fear started to manifest in our minds. There is a piece missing. Well, we found two pieces that stitched the Yorkie had chewed. It was either Stitch or it was Buddy the parrot. And then we came to it. We had a missing piece. The heartache and the devastation was felt by all, and even anger. Well, the puzzle ended up making great fire starters. I know you can order the missing pieces, but the children had more fun making fire. So you can imagine for a moment the feelings and emotions of the woman as they walked to the tomb that morning. They had witnessed Jesus' death on the cross. They were afraid. They were terrified. We know that they were talking because Mark gives us insight into their conversation. They were concerned about this huge big rock that concealed the entrance of the tomb. This is once again the point where I ask the question, where were the men disciples of Jesus? Full of fear and anxiety, the women made their way to the tomb to honor Jesus and give him the burial they felt he deserved. Never did they imagine what they were going to find there next. The tomb is open. Now, I don't know about you, but when I expect something to be one way and arrive and find it different, particularly if I leave and come home and the back door's open, I get afraid and nervous. We do live in South Africa after all. I find a weapon, normally it's a kitchen knife, and I go in to inspect. Mark tells us that they do not go looking for backup first, or even go look for a weapon. The ladies enter the tomb, and there they find a young man dressed in a white robe. Here they are given the wonderful news that Jesus is risen and that he has gone before them. Verse 8 brings or reminds us of the reality. The women do not leave singing and dancing, but they leave trembling and bewildered. These women have probably just encountered an angel and they have fled from the tomb. I wonder what their emotions were as they went through and experienced this. When I come home and find the door open, I don't admit to my wife and children I am terrified. I man up. I get my weapon and I walk in, showing my children, Daddy is courageous. Meanwhile, if they could just see or feel how my heart is trembling. It may have taken the woman some time to share the news, but here is the point I'm trying to make. If it were not for the woman sharing the news, there would be no resurrection story to share. The early evangelists, the early preachers of the risen Jesus Christ were not men, but they were women. According to John's Gospel, Mary goes to the tomb herself. Jesus reveals himself to Mary. He reveals himself to the women. The women are the ones to receive the news about the resurrection before the men. And so as we end the month of women, may we continue to celebrate the women in our lives. May we celebrate the women that play a huge role and the women that are not as prominent but are constant in our lives. Women are a gift, and we need to celebrate women, not just one month a year, but every day. Thank you for the women of the church, for all the women that have done something, that have participated, that have been there, that have been constant. We want to salute you. We want to honor you. And we want to say thank you. We know that we don't always express it, but today may we say thank you. Thank you to the woman that ministered to Jesus. Thank you to the woman that ministered in our churches. Thank you for the example that you have set to us. May we work as the body of Christ together with you to bring honor and glory to the risen Jesus Christ. Shall we pray? Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for women. We thank you for this past month in South Africa where we could celebrate Women's Month and celebrate the significance of the role of women in our lives, in our politics, in our nation, in our churches. Lord, we thank you that the Methodist Church celebrates for the first year a woman presiding bishop over South Africa or Southern Africa. We thank you, Father God, for her leadership and pray your blessing and your anointing upon her. Lord, we thank you for our district lady bishops. We thank you for our lady ministers. We thank you for our ladies in leadership in our local churches. Thank you, Father God, for the ladies that serve selflessly in the background. Lord, we want to honor them and we say thank you. May you bless them. And may they continue to be a blessing to those around them. We ask and pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
You call me out upon the waters, the great. Find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand, and I will call upon your name, and keep my eyes above the waves, when oceans rise, my soul. My soul will rest in.